If you're already subscribed to my channel, or if you found this video because you're already into RC crawling in particular, this might seem like a really weird question. When I'm Googling for just information about things, I'm seeing people also ask, is rock crawling fun? Is rock crawling boring? What's the point of rock crawling? And I thought, do you know what? That's actually a really good question. If you're not an enthusiast already, or if you haven't been bitten by the bug like so many of us have, you might actually be wondering, what's the point of walking around after a toy truck? These are slow, they're not fast jump trucks, they're not, you know, they're not high octane, they don't get your pulse racing.
I think it would just walk up these without a hassle.
So I've actually thought really hard about this, but I thought I'd share my thoughts with you because it's actually a really good question. And it made me appreciate just how much I value this hobby.
Any ideas?
It's a little bit of gratitude that could be helpful in times of trial, especially during COVID when a lot of us are still locked at home. I think the deeper question underneath these questions of is it fun or is it boring or what's the point? I think the deeper question is it worth investing my time into this thing? We all only have a limited time on the planet and we have limited resources. So what's...
Any ideas?
Why should I risk my resources on this hobby? We have a beautiful world full of so many different things. Why rock crawling? Why toy trucks? And so I thought about this and I thought, well, let's start with the wonder of being a kid. Things that go. They've always interested me and they interest a lot of you too, I'm sure. But to see a thing that goes on its own, there's a magic to that, you know? And I think I still have that wonder at things that go without touching them. I mean, yeah, okay, so you need a controller to control it, but you steer and it steers. You tell it to go and it goes. That is actually pretty magical. So I enjoy keeping that sense of wonder, and that's a big plus. And then the other thing that I really like is watching these things work on problems. There's a real joy in the scale element of them. Do you know, there's a video on my channel that I know most of you haven't watched because I can see how many people watch these things. I took number 2 in the country for the 1.9 mini class at the last nationals before COVID. In this little 5-minute video, I show the crawler off, and it's a comp crawler. It doesn't look like a scale vehicle. And I tell you about it, show it to you, and then I do a demo on the track. It's just a short video, but barely anyone's watched it. And I was thinking, you know, I think that's related to this question. It's not a scale truck. It's just basically wheels and a motor and as efficiently as possible to get this small thing around a course. So maybe scale is actually a big part of it. Maybe having something that looks like a truck that moves like a real truck where you can see the steering working. Obviously it's still a model, but to see something that looks like a real vehicle, I think there is actually value to that. So I think that's part of the popularity of crawling as well. And then of course there's the challenge of competition. Now I've got tennis balls behind me there, they're gates. And you have to get the truck through the different gates in order, and there's a challenge to that. Human beings have been attacking challenges for as long as there have been human beings, and when you add the challenge and the satisfaction of being able to beat a course with your truck and then improve on your time or improve on your best score, there's something to that. But then when you mix in people as well and competition, some people like to test themselves against others, and I think that's actually a really good thing. Another thing that I really like about crawling is being able to take one of these things out onto the trail. Before COVID, I would do this a couple of times a week. And during COVID, when I've been allowed to, I'm allowed to meet with one person within a certain radius outdoors for a limited time. I'm still doing that whenever I can, which is not very often, but whenever it's legal for me to do it, I'm doing it. Just getting out and having a little mini adventure with a mate, there's something really to it. So thanks, Simon, for that. And that brings me really to, I think, the main point about is rock crawling fun? And the answer is, yes, there's a real mental health benefit to it. Now, if you're watching this, chances are you're male. I know there are female viewers too, hello. But it's the guys I'm talking to here primarily on this point. We don't talk easily about how we feel or about our challenges necessarily. In my experience, blokes talk best when they're doing something, when they're working together or working against each other in something positive, you know? Or if there's a job to do, or if you're just doing something, that is kind of like the lubrication of conversation. And so standing around, holding one of these things, working a vehicle over a course with a mate or two, gee, there's something really wholesome about that, something really positive. I've had my own mental health struggles over the last decade in particular, and things got pretty bleak here and there. And being able to hang out with friends, rock crawling, and even just here on our property here, just playing on the rocks here, that's been a real salve to my emotional state at times, or my mental state. So the social element, being able to talk and just being able to hang out, that value is almost inexpressibly high. And so that's why I would say rock crawling is fun. If the sun's shining and you've got a crawler right now, it could be enough YouTube for now. Grab a battery, stick it in your truck and get out there. If it's safe to do so, call a mate and go hang out with him. Tell him how you're going. This might just be some of the secret spice that makes life so special. So throw me a like if this was useful to you, but more importantly, think about it, value the time you've got, and get out there and enjoy it, because gee, we have it good these days, eh? Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time on RC TNT.